as you are. Hear the Spirit's call. Come just as you are. Come and see. Receive. Come and live.
Receive, come and live for us. There is, there's a move of God in people's lives this morning. God is stirring the atmosphere.
Amen.
He's stirring things in people's lives. Not frivolous things, it's deep things. Prayer, asking for prayer, deep things. And I know some of us, it's the same way. God is, and you can't figure it out, and sometimes it's just hard to trust. We want to get our hands in it and take control. Get your hands out of it. God's got this. Whatever's going on in your life, God's got this. Take your hands off of it. Because you will do nothing but make it worse. You are living proof of that. I am living proof of that. I try to fix it. Let go. Turn it over to God. Give it to Him. Don't take it back. Let Him handle it. Because God's doing a mighty thing right now in some people's lives. He's doing a powerful thing right now in people's lives. Let Him work. God is blessing us even though we can't see it. Even though you may not feel it this morning, your tomorrow is planned by Him. Your tomorrow has been laid out by Him. Your tomorrow has been set on a calendar, and God's going to bless your tomorrow. I promise you that. I promise you that. He is faithful. He is faithful. So we're going to stand there. All made possible by the cross of Jesus Christ. Everything we have, everything we are, everything that we experience is made possible by the blood of Jesus Christ. So when He institutes something as simple as the Lord's Supper, it's not simple at all, is it? It's a doorway into His presence. Not only do you have to go to the cross, you got to go through the cross. It is the gateway into the presence of God. And He said, never forget that. Never forget that. Never forget that. And that's why He instituted the Lord's Supper. That we might know at the cross, where I first saw the light. Let's pray. Father God, we thank You for this, Your Lord's Supper. We ask that You bless them, Lord Father. Bless the loaf, bless the fruit of the vine. Nothing in them have sacred meaning, but what they represent is holy ground. Your body, Your presence, Your sacrifice. Holy ground, Father. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You for loving us. Thank You for instituting this on our behalf, that we might be able to stand in Your presence. Honor You with this memorial. It's in Your name we pray. Amen and amen. Won't you join us as we take the Lord's Supper this morning?
Jesus.
Tonight at 6 o'clock, Bible study. We'll be here. Tonight we're going to be talking about the compassion of Christ. Is our subject matter for tonight. So I hope you can be here for that. Wednesday night, no meals to be cooked, but Jeremy inspired me the week before. So I'm going to make this suggestion, and you're welcome to do it or welcome not to do it. I don't care. Jeremy brought his dinner with him. Came in, burgers, a couple of milkshakes, or I guess that's what they were, right?
Yeah.
The only problem was, I said, hey, can I have some? He goes, yeah. He said, you can have a sip. I said, really? I said, what is it? He says, Reese's peanut butter.
Thank you anyway.
After he got up. So I'm just saying to you, if you want to bring a sack lunch, we'll be here at 6. If you want to bring a sack lunch and sit down with us, or you want to stop by one of them fast food places that will make you sick and fat if you eat, I'm kidding. If you want to stop by, pick up a pizza on the way, they're only $5 up here. We'll just sit down and eat together if you want to do that. Nobody's cooking, but if you just want to bring, you know, a Brussels sprout sandwich with you, we'll just share it together. Okay, Bible study at 7. We're talking about the promises of God. We're just having fun with that. We're not doing prayer and meditation until September. Like the meals and prayer and meditation is going to be discontinued to give some people some rest break till the first week of September. The last Sunday of August, start thinking about this, is our anniversary, church anniversary. Okay? And we're going to do some of the same things we did last year, such as get a card, fill out a card. You know, some of the interesting things people wrote about, you know, freedom. Do that. And if you can, because we're at that time of the season, if you have a little extra offering you give, stick it in there as a blessing offering. Our finances are okay. We're not as bad as we were last year, but you know how the summer depletes us. And so if you can stick a little
something,
we appreciate it. We really would like your thoughts about what freedom has meant to you on the cards, and we want to share those, and we'll share those in the service. We got a couple of other things that we need to talk about. We're not there yet. So, but the last Sunday of the month, great time to bring somebody and say, hey, we're celebrating. We'd love to have you here with us. So, did I miss any other announcements? No?
Thursday morning.
Oh, I'm sorry, Thursday morning. Thank you. So, we are doing Thursday morning. Okay. Anybody else? Let's pray for that. Father God, thank you so much for your blessed hand. Thank you, Father, for the faithfulness of this family to help with the finances and to be a part of all that we're doing, the ministry and growing. We've taken on some things, and we want to take on more, Father. So open the door, Father, for people to come in to bring their gifts and talents to us that they might be used in a mighty way. We thank you, Father, for the jobs you've provided and the jobs you're going to provide for people, for an opportunity to earn a living, to pay their bills, and to bless you. Father, I just love what you're doing here and how you're doing it. Thank you. Accept this offering on our behalf. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Time to take up the offering.
Yeah.
can't scratch.
Uh-oh.
No, really. Okay, we'll close off, but I need to do something. I know you noticed that things changed a little bit this morning. We've got curtains up everywhere. Well, we didn't, I just want to say to you, we did not purchase those. We purchased this set, and Lampstand liked it so well, they went out and bought the curtains and put it up because of the glare and stuff. Let me ask you a question. Well, I like it. Here's the thing. We can open them up if you want them opened up, or we can close them. We're trying to keep the glare off. One of their young people said, well, it keeps people, during your sermon, it keeps people from focusing on the outside. And I said, excuse me, young lady, my people are focused on me. They ain't looking outside. I said, except for the two that fall asleep every Sunday. Everybody else, I'm not kidding. So, anybody just hate it so bad you might not come to church again? Okay, sometimes we'll open them, sometimes we'll close them, whatever I feel like.
Okay.
Are you okay with that? I kind of like them closed myself, but that's just me. I don't know. Do what?
Have you noticed? Did it? Yes. Really? Cooler?
Oh, yeah, it would turn the heat. Yeah, that's true. Okay, I didn't even think about that. See, I don't know.
It's very hot right here.
Right. And I thought that was my preaching. No, thank you very much. Anyway, great day today. Amen.
Amen.
Glad you were here and take part in the Bible studies coming up. God is just moving in a mighty way, folks. I'm telling you. Just feel His presence. And so, don't jump in the deep end. That's what you just need to do. Jump in the deep end. All right, let's pray. Father God, this has been a wonderful day. Mostly because we just get to experience you. I thank you for the praise and the music and the words and the talents of the praise team. I thank you for them, for those that help in the sound and help throw the words up. I thank you for Lou and Lydia and all that they do. I thank you for all of them. I thank you, Father, for your word. Take that word. Bless our lives this week. Transform our lives. Let us share with those around us the hope that we find in you. It's been an awesome day, Father. As we go into the workplace, continue to bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Thank you. Have a great week.